In the Father's house we shall meet Buddhists and Jews, Muslims and Protestants, even a few Catholics. I dare say we should be more humble about people who, even if they have never heard of the name of Jesus Christ, may well be more Christian than we are. I quoted these words from the late Brazilian Archbishop Dom Helder Câmara. Dear friends, God is kind and merciful to his people without any distinction, and he takes care of them. He is the true source of nourishment for our lives, and we have to share with others what we have at our disposal. This is what we see in today's readings. The multiplication of bread and fish is found twice each in the Gospels of Matthew and Mark, once in Luke and once in John. In all these presentations, Jesus takes the bread, breaks it, and gives it to the disciples. These same words are used at the Last Supper. However, there is a special focus in the Gospel of St. John. In John, Jesus has a tremendous compassion for the people whom he sees as hungry for God. The multiplication is not simply referred to as a miracle, rather, it is a very special sign, a sign of the way that the Lord wants to feed us. He sees our weaknesses, our tendencies towards selfishness, anger and pride, and he sees how we belong to become more different than we are. He also sees our mortality and our longing for eternity. Here, the sign of the multiplication is the sign of the sacrament of the Eucharist. Today, we begin a 5-week discussion about the food that Jesus gives us. This Sunday's Gospel begins the 6th chapter of the Gospel according to John, the chapter on the bread of life. We are the disciples whom Jesus tells to feed the people. We don't have enough to feed them all. We don't have enough to provide for all their needs. This is true. But we bring what we have to the Lord, and he transforms it into more and better than we can ever imagine. And then we feed his people, and we too eat. Here we may make a personal reflection. Is my faith weak? Is my love limited? I am continually drawn away from the Lord. How can I make Jesus present to this generation, to the people I work with, to the people in the neighborhood, and more important, to my own family? Jesus says, take the faith you have, the love you have, bring it to me. I will transform it. I will multiply it. Look at what I did with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. Bring what you have to me. I will multiply it. It will be more than enough for them and for you. According to St. John, the multiplication took place at the time of the Passover. This isn't just a random fact thrown in to enhance the story. Or another Passover, at the Last Supper, Jesus would give his body and blood. The bread at the multiplication does not magically appear. He takes what they have, then he gives thanks. he pronounces Eucharist, which means give thanks. He tells the disciples to gather up the leftover fragments. The Lord's gift is his body and blood. Once transformed, or when transubstantiation takes place, the bread and wine become Jesus' body and blood. The fragments, the leftover host we keep after the communion, remain his body and blood. We place them in the tabernacle to feed the sick. We place them in the tabernacle to adore his Eucharistic presence. We take one and put it in a special container, a monstrance. The word means showing. And we show the divine presence to the people and bless them with his presence, and we have the Eucharistic adoration. Dear friends, when I reflect upon this, I feel that my faith is weak. My love is limited. And your faith also may be weak, your love may be limited, but the fact is that there is no limits with Jesus. We seek his holy presence, and he gives us his body and blood to take within us. And then the real hunger begins. The more I eat of him, the hungrier I get. I am hungry for Christ. You are hungry for Christ. The more we receive him, the more we want him. That's why retreats, weeks with the Lord, those special periods of the church year, Lent, Easter, Advent, Christmas, all of these times don't just strengthen the presence of the Lord in our lives, but moreover, they lead us to want more and more. It increases our hunger and thirst. Such is the wonderful contradiction of Christianity in general and the Eucharist in particular. He fills us, and yet he always leaves us wanting more and more. My dear friends, when we go deeper into the meaning here, we see that Jesus is the true source of nourishment and fulfillment for our lives. If we want to share that nourishment, we have to listen to him. We have to be prepared to enter totally with him into the Paschal mystery of his love-centered life, his self-giving in sacrifice, sufferings, and death as a way to life. Here comes the question: how can we know that we are being nourished by God? For this, we get some pointers in today's second reading. Second Saint Paul writes as a prisoner, and like thousands of Christian prisoners since, he is denied the Eucharist. He asks us to live our lives in a way which is worthy of the calling in which we have been called. And finally, the life implication here is very simple. The life implication in this particular gospel passage is simple. Jesus wants to work the miracle of feeding a huge number of people who are hungry. But the miracle will not happen without someone to provide 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. Jesus must have loved the boy who was willing to share what was really his to eat. The miracle of the gospel is as much about the boy as it is about Jesus. And today, the boy is each of us. Each of us who is something to offer the Lord. Jesus does not spiritualize the hunger of the poor or postpone his love for them to the next world. As late Archbishop, the Brazilian Archbishop Dom Helder Câmara who was also known as Brazil's Archbishop of the Poor, once said, I quote him, "When I feed the poor, they call me a saint. When I ask why so many people are poor, they call me a communist." Today, the Lord asks all sorts of people who have influence in shaping public policy to make their contribution by keeping Heller Camara's question in the forefront of debate about political, social, and economic policies. The contribution of those who seek solutions to the very difficult question of Heller Camara is as essential as the contribution of those who are daily engaged in the immediate relief of starving people. And regardless of the effort, there will always be the feeling, but what good is this among so many? My dear friends, if God gave us the natural resources, the brains, and the will to achieve what we have in our world through science and technology, it is likely that with Christ, we can also bring about the miracle of every child of God having enough to eat. Jesus feels so deeply about this that he said, if someone is hungry, it is he himself who is hungry, which we see in Matthew 25 verses from 31 to 46. As we celebrate our Eucharist today, let us recall to the truth that Jesus is present in the total reality of his body. The body of Christ includes a large number of people. All are dear to him. The question is, can we celebrate the Eucharist authentically and be indifferent to their plight? God bless you.